Good evening, Munir Ajam, one more time. Last video for today, and this is a continuation of the previous video on estimating. In the previous video, we concentrated on what are the components of a good estimate, and in this video, we will focus on what are the component. What is required to develop a good estimate. Not sure how to approach this video, but I am thinking that I will be talking from a client type organization that want to estimate a project before they go out to bid the project, and this would be useful in order to avoid having to wait on bids from the contractors to decide on what will be the project cost. And of course, this would also help to avoid manipulation, potential manipulation from the market. So ideally, it would be great if client type organization can develop good estimate for them to use it for funding the project, to get final approval from their boards, their management for approving the project. And also it could be detailed enough to use for control purposes once the project is approved and move into the implementation stage. Well, to develop good estimate, obviously we need to think back on the engines of project management, which is focus on the concept of process, people, and tools. In this case, for project management estimating, we need to have good tools. The process is very important because we need to have an estimating system that help us to develop good cost estimate. And obviously we need qualified people who understand estimating and the different type of estimate and whether the estimate they're developing will be used in early stages of the project, such as for the feasibility, which would be conceptual order magnitude estimate, or potentially something they can develop during development stages of the project, and they could use an estimate for planning purposes or to help gauge to see if the project is continuing, or whether it is the final estimate that's usually done for funding purposes and control. So we need people, process, and tools. Tools could be as simple as Excel or could be sophisticated computer software, whether developed in-house or there are some commercial, probably depend on the industry, there might be some commercial applications out there. But regardless what tools you use, obviously we need the people that have experience, but let me focus here on the process. The estimating process involve multiple things. First, the organization must have good organizational project management system. We go back to this concept times and times again in these videos to talk about OPM. Without a proper organizational project management system, which consists of the processes and procedures and guidelines, but also the organizational knowledge base, historical file, lessons learned, and good data, there is no way you can do a good estimate. Let's be clear from the beginning here, is that unless you have good system and good procedures and guidelines and good data, yeah, is not estimating, you might as well forget about it. Yeah, you probably be more guessing or doing guesswork or magic rather than proper estimating. So data, where does it come from? It must come from historical data, meaning from previous project. Organization that have done project for many years, they should have an excellent data bank, knowledge bank, organizational record that include the various cost estimate, the various cost estimate from previous project, but it also it include the cost of the various component of the things they typically use in their project. Obviously, if you do real estate, you should have good database of prices of material, concrete, steel, flooring, paints, and whatever. If you work in the oil and gas, petrochemical industry, you should have good ideas about prices of pumps and vessels and instrumentation and control system and electrical. So regardless what type of work you do, you need to have good data of the things you use the most. And of course, good idea about labor and what does it take to install a certain piece of equipment or a certain item. And then, of course, we need also a system where it is easy to collect all that information and use it on our estimating system. Now, there are different type of estimates. We talk about analogous or factored estimate or parametric or bottom-up. In the future, we can talk about maybe those estimates. But today, ideally, we're talking about the control estimate or the budget estimate, which must be you based on bottom-up estimating technique, which is meaning you are used estimating based on detailed breakdown of the work at the work package level. And that's where you need the data to be. If you do not have data at the work package level, then technically you cannot do this estimate. If your data only at the project level, then you can only do analogous estimating, which is not really good enough estimating for budgeting and control. So maybe time to summarize. We cannot go into a lot of details in these short videos. We need people, process, and tools. Tools will be based on whatever organization or system you have. It could be software you buy from the market or you develop yourself or Excel sheets. People, they have to be able to understand the different type of estimate and they have experience enough to be able to know what's required to include in an estimate, just such as the topics we discussed in the previous video. But the most important thing is the process, which include, in this case, when we talk about processes, we're talking about the system, the procedures, the guideline, in addition to the corporate knowledge base and historical data that should be available in detail. These are key factors to do proper estimating. Without them, we can say goodnight. No use to continue.